Today we'll visit a small New Jersey suburb where the parents of high school seniors work all year to create a graduation night to remember and prevent prom night tragedies. Glen Rock, New Jersey is a quiet town of about 13,000. It's a fairly prosperous town with a deep and genuine concern for the well-being of its young people. For the past year, in basements, school storage rooms, behind locked doors and blacked out windows, the parents of the high school seniors have been painting, building, sculpting, and sewing to transform the high school gym into a community graduation gift. Last June, the parents elected Leonard Pfeiffer chairman of the graduation ball committee, and he's been a busy man ever since.
We have a relatively new high school here, and our first graduation was, I believe, in 1958. And prior to that time, we had heard of a tragedy in another town on the night of graduation where four youngsters were killed through a combination of automobile and high speed and liquor. And the students and the parents who were involved back in those early days thought that we would like to do something here to prevent anything like that. And that was really the birth of the idea of our graduation ball in Glen Rock. And we know, and that, shall I say, they knew, that the minute you say the youngsters have to come to something, that you wouldn't get all of them. So they took a different approach, and they tried to have an evening so interesting and full of so much fun that they all look forward to this now for 4 years. So that is not our problem, getting everyone to come. We have 40 committees working on this thing, and we've been working on it, oh, really, since before last year's graduation, because it's our group that had to take last year's ball down and put it away and store it and see what we could use and salvage for this year's use. But we have, of course, committees that do that. Design our theme, choose a theme, and make all the design preparations. Others that do painting of the sets and the background. Of course, we have a construction crew because much of the stuff has to be built.
We started by making elevations of each wall of the gym. And the artist took that elevation, which is on a transparency, and painted, and sketched and painted those transparencies. And in turn, they were put on a projected on these flats, and then we sketched a pencil outline onto the flat with a letter for green or blue, and then all the gals can come in at any time and fill in these flats, and then they will be installed on the walls of the gym according to the numbers on the back and the plans. And that's the way we get our decorations for the gym, which will be the Forbidden City of China. That's the theme of the prom. Here is a sample of a dragon that Fran is working on that's going to be part of the walls of the gym. When they're all put together, the thing is gorgeous.
We have ticket committees, we have dinner committees, punch committees, committees to make reservations to make sure that everyone has an opportunity to come to this ball, because sometimes there are youngsters that, well, even though they're seniors in high school, are a little bashful or shy and just need a little help to encourage them to come out to enjoy an evening like this. We try to make it as close to 100% as possible.
Several years ago, because of rumors that the kids were no longer interested in a ball, the parents, not wanting to go through all that work for nothing, took a survey, and the results were encouraging. Better than 99% of the students were in favor of continuing the tradition. Since that survey, the laws of New Jersey have changed. The drinking age is now 18. But because the ball is held on school property, liquor is prohibited. Now, legally, many of the students would be adults by graduation time, and perhaps this prohibition would turn them off. So we asked them if they were still looking forward to going to the ball.
Yes, I'm looking very much forward to the prom.
I'm looking forward to the prom because I consider it the culmination of all 6 years of high school.
Does the fact that no liquor is allowed in the ball bother you?
Not at all. I'm not a drinker.
I want to go to the senior prom because it's the last time that the seniors can get together as a class.
I think that the way the parents do it now is, I think it's really great. They keep it secret and everything, and we really don't know what's going on, and it's really, the suspense really builds up, and, you know, I'm really anxious to see what they've been doing in there all these months and everything.
Does the fact that you're 18 and there's no liquor allowed bother you?
No, it doesn't bother me at all.
Well, we've had a junior prom and a senior prom back in the winter, two different proms before this, and we always know what it's going to be like. We do all the work, and here we don't have to do any of the work ourselves, which is good in itself. And two, it's a surprise, and surprises are always better than something that you can, you know, that you're expecting.
I'm looking very forward to going to the proms. It's one of the highlights of my whole senior year, and I remember my sister going 4 years ago, and now it's my turn, and it's even more exciting.
It's one of the biggest things that the school has to offer, and it's like a big pinnacle to the whole year. We've worked 5 years of hard work, and now the day's come where we're finished school and we can just celebrate and forget about all our schoolwork.
You think this is a good thing for a community to get into?
I think it's really good because it gets all the parents of the class together, and you know, most of them don't even know each other, and it's a good thing to get the whole class and the parents together and really get the whole town together.
Are you going with him?
No, not yet.
Hint?
Maybe.
For several weeks, an air of excitement and anticipation prevailed, as last-minute preparations kept many parents at the gym far into the night. Finally, the big day arrived, Monday, June 25th. Graduation ceremonies were held early in the evening, about 6 o'clock. This would give the students enough time to get home to change into tuxes and gowns for the ball which was set to start. After the graduation ceremonies, the parents and guests would be allowed to get a peek at the ballroom. But the students would not know what the theme was going to be until that night.
Them. Around midnight, we served them a complete meal, in keeping again with the theme of the evening. The kick for all of the parents is that they know they're doing something for the youngsters, and you know there are so many good youngsters around, not only in our town but all towns, that they deserve something, we feel, and it does take a lot of time and a lot of effort, but we feel it's worth it because, one, we are preventing a tragedy, preventing any accidents, I think, by keeping them here in town. And all of them go home to get into more comfortable clothes, sport clothes or what have you, and by 4 o'clock they are all invited to some home throughout town for breakfast parties for 2 hours from 4 to 6. We have the pool downtown open for them with lifeguards and all, so that they can take an early morning dip for a couple hours and picture taking. And usually by that time, if there's one thing they're interested in, that's getting back home and getting some sleep. But they've had a real complete evening and morning.
After the ball is over, after the break of dawn, after the dancer